Heading profitability ratios. You have already noted down gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, then operating ratio. So you have already noted down. Now the next is operating profit ratio.
Or sir.
Or sir, this.
Operating profit ratio. And this formula I have already given you. That was the part of formula. But if that formula was applicable when operating cost ratio was given. Hundred minus operating ratio. This is applicable when you calculate operating ratio. If operating ratio is not given in the problem, then how to proceed? At that time, we use the second formula, that is equal to operating profit divided by
net
sales
into 100.
Operating profit divided by net sales into 100. Then next, this was fourth type of ratio which we discussed. The next one is fifth one. That is return on investment. Return on investment, or you can also call it as return on capital employed. Return on capital employed. Now, return on capital employed. The formula is, it is equal to profit before interest and tax. Profit before interest and tax divided by capital employed divided by capital employed, or you can say net assets, because both means same, whether it is capital employed or net assets, into 100. Next, number 6. Return on shareholders' funds. Return on shareholders' funds. Return on shareholders' funds. The formula is, it is equal to profit after tax. profit after tax divided by shareholders funds. Divided by shareholders funds into 100. Into 100. Now, number 7. Number 7. Earning per share. Earning per share equal to profit available to equity shareholders, profit available to equity shareholders divided by number of equity shares. Number of equity shares. Next, number 8. Book value per share. Book value per share is equal to equity share holders funds. Book value per share is equal to equity shareholders funds divided by number of equity shares. Divided by number of equity shares. And next, number 9. Dividend payout ratio. Dividend payout ratio is equal to dividend per share dividend per share divided by earning per share divided by earning per share. And the last one is price earning ratio. Price earning ratio is equal to is equal to market price of a share. Market price of a share divided by earning per share. Market price of a share divided by earning per share. So these are the ratios which you are required to know. So totally 10 profitability ratios. Let me tell you the meaning of each ratio, why they are calculated. So the first one is operating profit ratio. Operating profit ratio is calculated to understand how much profit you have earned after spending operating expenses. So that is known as operating ratio. Okay, so that profit percentage is known as operating profit ratio. It tells you the percentage of profit after deducting only operating expenses. Next, the second is return on investment. That means how much of amount you have earned on net assets. I will tell you what is net assets. Net assets formula do hai. Ek hai total assets minus current liabilities. Remember, total assets minus current liabilities. And one more formula for profit before interest and tax for capital employed is shareholders funds plus non-current liability. If you remember in your balance sheet, Roman 1 ke baad jo first aata tha, that was shareholders funds, wo ek lena, and jo second hai, wo bhi lena, that is non-current liability, and when you add both, that becomes capital employed. And what is profit before interest and tax? The net profit before charging interest and tax, that is called as profit before interest and tax. And the next is return on shareholders funds. Sixth one, return on shareholders funds. That means the amount of shareholders funds, how much return they have received on their funds. That is called as return on shareholders funds. The formula for that is profit after tax. Remember, it is not earning before interest and tax. It is profit after tax. So what is meant by shareholders funds? This we have already seen in debt. Equity share capital, preference share capital, reserves plus profit, and if any losses are there, it should be deducted. Next, number 6. प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स भी आपको मालूम है, जो प्रॉफिट है, प्रॉफिट बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स है, उसमें इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स डिडक्ट करने के बाद जो अमाउंट आता है, दैट इज नोन एज प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स. एंड 7th इज अर्निंग पर शेयर. दैट मींस इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट ऑन ईच शेयर हाउ मच आई हैव अर्नड. सो दैट्स व्हाई, एंड दिस विल बी कैलकुलेटेड ओनली फॉर इक्विटी शेयर्स, एंड प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड हियर. So that's why the formula which we use is profit available to equity shareholders. Profit available to equity shareholders divided by number of equity shares is considered. You need to remember, divided by number of equity shares only. And even profit available to equity shareholders should be taken. Now question arises, sir, what is difference between profit after tax and profit available to equity shareholders? Remember, out of the profit after tax which is available, first dividend is paid to preference shareholders and whatever remains that will be paid to equity shareholders. So that's why we need to consider the profit available to equity shareholders. The next is divided by number of equity shares that we can easily get. Be available in book value per share. Now, what is book value? I will tell you. Remember, it is not just capital which belongs to shareholders. Even the reserves and surplus also belongs to shareholders. At that time, what we need to do is we need to first check equity shareholders' funds. What is mean by equity shareholders' funds? Equity share capital, reserve, surplus. जब सब add करेंगे तो मिलेगा क्या? Equity shareholders' funds. Divided by number of equity shares, we will get book value per share. See, remember, for earning we divide profit by number of equity shares, and for book value we divide equity shareholders funds. Hope you remember, shareholders funds first head under which we have taken share capital and reserves and surplus, both should be taken there as equity shareholders funds. The next is dividend payout ratio. Formula, what is meant by dividend payout ratio? Out of your earning, how much you have paid as dividend, that is given by dividend payout ratio. So that is, the formula is dividend per share divided by earning per share. The next is price earning ratio. So price earning ratio, so the market price, sometime it increases, decreases. So in order to identify how much we have earned on the market price of the shares, the formula which we use is market price of the shares divided by earning per share. So that is the last formula which we have to learn. Hope all of you have noted down.
Yes sir.
Sab logon ne note kiya hai?
Yes sir.
You check in your question bank from 1 to 5. कौन से questions अभी missing है solve कराना. Till that time I erase.
Sir, third and fourth didn't run, sir.
अभी एक प्रॉब्लम आ रहा पेंडिंग है ना.
9th one पेंडिंग सर. 9th one पेंडिंग सर.
9th one आई थिंक हाफ वे हैव डन.
यस सर.
सो चलो लेट्स कंप्लीट इट. प्रॉब्लम नंबर 9. व्हाट इज द पेज नंबर? 131. Yes, in that number 4, operating profit ratio. Is operating profit divided by net sales into 100. Operating profit divided by net sales into 100. The operating profit is 16 lakhs divided by 20 lakhs into 100. That comes to, just check whether it is 80%.
Yes, sir.
Next. Number five. Dividend payout ratio. Dividend payout ratio. Now, in that dividend payout ratio is equal to dividend per share divided by earning per share. Just check whether the formula is right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Dividend per share divided by earning per share. Now, can somebody tell me what is earning per share, what is dividend per share here?
1.6.
They have given earning per share as 1.67, if you see.
Yes, sir.
Exactly?
Yes, sir.
Now, can you tell me what is dividend per share? What is dividend per share? जल्दी बताइए. Percent debentures are 1 lakh in percent and tax is 20,000 and preference shareholders dividend is 20,000. Okay, now see how to ascertain the dividend per share. Just check working on. First, we need to ascertain what is dividend. Now, dividend per share. So, first, dividend is equal to earning before interest and tax minus interest minus tax minus preference dividend.
Can you
minus preference dividend? Okay. Now, देखिए मैं आपको और एक बार समझाता हूं. From the earning before interest and tax, in order to get the earnings, we need to remove interest and we need to remove tax. So, what we will be getting? earning after tax we will be getting, or you can call it as profit. And from that profit after tax, we need to remove preference dividend so that we come to know how much dividend we have paid to equity shareholders. So that's why I have removed preference dividend here. So now, the earning before interest and tax. There is a last point, net profit after tax. Diya gaya hai udhar. Can you see it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Usme aapko net profit before interest and tax karo usko. Last wale ko. Net profit before interest and tax. Which is nothing but 1 lakh. Ye wala. माइनस इंटरेस्ट जो है, यू कैन सी 13% डिबेंचर. द नेम 13% डिबेंचर मींस दैट देयर विल बी 13% इंटरेस्ट ऑन देम. सो दैट्स व्हाई इंटरेस्ट विल बी कैलकुलेटेड एज 1 लाख इनटू 13%. 1 लाख इनटू 13%. Next, minus tax. I think the tax amounted to rupees 20,000. Tax amounted to rupees 20,000. Minus the preference dividend is 10%, which means 20,000 again. How it is? It is 1 lakh into 20%. आप देख सकते हैं, it is 1 lakh into 20%, because आप preference share capital के पास जाइए, देखिए आप उसे 10% preference shares of rupees 10, total it is 2 lakh. So 2 lakh का जो 10% है, it will be 20,000. Hence, I have considered it as 20,000. Okay. Now, next it will be, I think it will be 47,000. 47,000. Just check whether it will be 47,000.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next is dividend per share. We have to ascertain dividend per share is equal to what is total dividend? 47,000. याद रखिए, the total dividend is 47,000 divided by 50,000. Now question arises, from where you got this 50,000? You just go to paid up share capital बोल के एक टाइटल है, उधर जाइए. Paid up share capital. Total कितना है देखिए, capital 5 lakh है. है या नहीं?
Yes, sir.
And एक शेयर की वैल्यू 10 rupees है, आप देख सकते हैं. Paid up share capital in bracket rupees 10 each. So 5 lakh divided by 10 करेंगे तो कितना आएगा? It will be 50,000. Now, can somebody give me what will be the value of 47,000 divided by
0.94 sir.
Exactly 94.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it is 0.94. So now coming to this point, dividend per share is 0.94 and earning per share is 1.67. Can somebody tell me what will be the result?
0.56
per share. 0.56 per share. Now, last is book value per share. Book value per share. So now, book value per share is equal to shareholders' funds. Shareholders' funds. Divided by number of equity shares. Number of equity shares. Now, here, I don't know working note number kitna hai, aap kal ka hi continue kijiye. So I write here share holders funds is equal to equity share capital plus preference share capital plus equity share capital plus preference share capital plus reserve plus profit plus reserve plus profit. Now, equity share capital is 5 lakh plus we have to consider only equity share capital, not preference. Because it is, so it will be plus reserve plus profit. So here, equity share capital is 5 lakh. Reserves are 0. And the profit is 1 lakh. You can see at the end.
Sir, so general reserves. General reserves.
What?
General reserve.
Oh, sorry, you have to take general reserve only as 1 lakh. Okay, just a minute. That net profit should not be considered because it is not profit after tax. That is not given in the problem. So, 5 lakh plus 1 lakh plus 0. Now, why that profit should not be considered, I will tell you. Because it is net profit before interest and tax. We need to consider this surplus. Surplus means even it is not exactly profit after tax. Out of profit after tax, after paying dividend, whatever amount not available in the problem, hence we are going to drop it and I have taken it as zero. So 5 lakh rupees is paid up share capital, that is equity share capital, plus 1 lakh is reserve and the surplus is 0. So total comes to 6 lakh. So now here, shareholders' funds are 6 lakh divided by number of equity shares is 15,000. Now that also I will make a working note. That is number of equity shares. Number of equity shares is equal to equity share capital divided by number of shares, divided by number of shares. So now equity share capital is 5 lakh divided by face value is 10. How you come to know face value is 10? Because they have mentioned that shares